it's holiday time, people come to Tasmania from all over Australia to look at our island. Some of these tourists come here. Others arrive by boat. They all want to see our beautiful scenery and historical landmarks. Visitors often need advice about hotels and transport, and there is a government tourist bureau to help them. Here you can make bookings for all sorts of trips and excursions. One of the most popular places for tourists in Tasmania is Port Arthur on the Tasman Peninsula. To find the Tasman Peninsula on the map of Tasmania, you have to look in the southeast corner of the island, down here. From Hobart, the road runs across the Derwent River, past the airport at Cambridge, Burrell, on to the fishing port of Dunalley, and soon we come to Eaglehawk Neck, at the top of the Tasman Peninsula. From the road leading down to Eaglehawk Neck, we can look out over Pirates Bay and see the rugged coast of the peninsula. From the hill on the other side, we look back over Eaglehawk Neck itself. In the days when there was a big convict settlement on the peninsula, a line of savage dogs guarded this narrow strip of land. But all that remains here now is the old house, which used to be the quarters for the military officers. A little way along the road is the Lufra Hotel. Lots of tourists stay here, and everyone goes down to the shore to look at the tessellated pavement. Nature has split the face of the rock into these square shapes, but they look as if they'd been carved by stonemasons. There are some more strange rock formations on the other side of Pirates Bay. This one is called Tasman's Arch. It is a huge gateway through the face of the cliff, nearly 200 feet high. Another place that tourists always visit is the blowhole. The waves rush into the blowhole through a long tunnel in the cliff. On a stormy day, it's a fine sight to see. The Devil's Kitchen is another exciting place nearby. There's a sheer drop here that will take your breath away. Now, let's go down the road from Eaglehawk Neck to Port Arthur, 12 miles away in the south of the peninsula. Port Arthur lies in a beautiful ship surrounded by green hills and native bush. The town was founded as a prison settlement in 1830 by Colonel George Arthur, the governor of the colony. 100 years ago, this was the third biggest town in Tasmania, with a population of 9,000 people. It was the main penal station in the island, but it was closed down in the year 1887. Across the water lies the main prison block. It used to hold 650 men, but bushfires and the passing of the years have left it in ruins, like most of the other old buildings at Port Arthur. Some of them have disappeared without leaving even a trace behind. Tourists are always interested in the old church, which was designed by one of the prisoners. The guide says that it used to have a shingle roof, but it was burnt in a fire, and the tall steeple was blown down in a gale long ago. On to the model prison next. This is in ruins too. Prisoners used to be kept in the model prison alone and in silence. Discipline was harsh in those days. This is the old lunatic asylum. It is one of the few old buildings in Port Arthur that has not been badly damaged. Nearby is the powder magazine, where all the ammunition for the settlement was stored. It was a fine stronghold for officers in case of mutiny, too. Next door to the magazine is the mansion where the commandant of the settlement lived. Now it is a private home, like some of the other old buildings, such as the rectory, which has become the Port Arthur post office. In the bay, where the supply ships used to drop anchor, you see many fishing boats now, for a lot of people on the Tasman Peninsula earn their living from the sea. Just south of Port Arthur is a beautiful spot called Safety Cove, where some of the earliest explorers took shelter. There's another strange rock formation beyond Safety Cove. This one is called Remarkable Cave. The hole at the end is nearly the same shape as Tasmania. Away in the distance, you can see the southernmost point of the peninsula. Now, let's take the road to Nubeena on the west coast. The country around Nubeena is steep and hilly, and there are many small farms where crops are grown and sheep and cattle are raised. Nestling in the fertile valleys, we find splendid apple and pear orchards too. When the blossom is on the trees, it's time for spraying to keep the fruit crop free of disease. This is Parsons Bay on the west coast, part of the deep inlet called Wedge Bay, on which Nubeena lies. Nubeena is a quiet little place and very sheltered, so a lot of fishermen live there. It's a fine place for holidays too, if you like swimming and fishing. From Nubeena, two roads lead to the north of the peninsula. One goes to Premaydena and the northwest, and the other Gacunya, then back to Eaglehawk Neck. Along the Premaydena Road, there are some glorious views over the coast. We pass through good farming land, where cattle and sheep crop the grassy hillsides. On the north coast at Cunha, there are fine orchards too. At Saltwater River, west of Premaydena, stands the ruin of the convict coal mining station. 500 tons of coal were shipped mines. More than 50 years ago, they caught a light in a bushfire, and the coal is still smoldering underground today. There are plenty of interesting places to see on the Tasman Peninsula, aren't there? It's no wonder so many tourists come here for their holidays. Let's look at some snapshots of the peninsula. First of all, here's Eaglehawk Neck in the north. That's where the line of watchdogs was kept. Here is a group of tourists visiting those strange rock formations we saw. This is what they were looking at. Tasman's Arch. Here is the old ruined church at Port Arthur, the town that was the center of the convict settlement. This is one of the orchards in the valleys around Nubeena on the west coast. That was where we saw the fruit trees being sprayed. And here is some of that grand coastal scenery. The Tasman Peninsula is one of the best places for a holiday in all Tasmania.